Kirk, Marianne, and number 99. It's the 98 Rock Purple Power Hour with Odafe Oweh. Powered by 212 Realty. A journey beyond, a degree above.
Odafe Oweh, the Purple Power Hour. What's
making
up?
It happen.
Dude, that was, wow, what a game. Tough 42-38 loss to the Dolphins. And I'm gonna tell you what, man. That last quarter, it was hard to watch, but glad it's early in the season. Plenty of time to clean things up and get it right for the Patriots coming up on Sunday. So where's your head, 99, after that one yesterday?
Yeah, it was definitely a roller coaster of emotions. You know, everything was happening pretty fast, but, you know, we got to get better as a defense, you know, as a unit, especially, you know, closing games out, making sure that, you know, our opponent doesn't get the best of us, especially when our offense is scoring like that. Like, they were scoring. And they were
on fire.
Lamar was doing, you know, ungodly things like he usually does. Bate got his tutty. Was looking crazy, obviously. So, yeah, we got to help our offense out and capitalize and seal the game out. Multiple things that we got to get better at. But, you know, we got another chance this weekend. So, to prove to the team that we're the defense that we are, and so we'll be good.
Odafe, I was talking to my mom on the way in, because I often do, especially after game day. And she said, oh, he's probably going to be not happy. And I said, you know, I think these guys, like, this is my guess, I don't know, that this is what you do for a living. And it's like, not is it as emotional for you as a player as it is for the spectators? Because, you know, people get sad after a loss, but I wonder if players are just like, this is my job.
I mean, I feel like it would be more emotional for us because, like, we're going through it. And it's like, I know it seems crazy to you guys, but we're like, we're in it. Like, it's happening to us. So, like, and then we got to go through, you know, everyone, you know, the coaches, obviously, and then, you know, disappointing the fans and everything. But we understand that football is football, and, like, it takes little things for it to go the other ways. And we know that the things that we got beat on, it was us. It wasn't necessarily what they were doing. So, you know, us as football players, we know what we can do to make sure we win that game we played it again. So and you can't ever have that mentality of that, you know, get sad about a loss like that, because you got to play the next week. So.
Right. Shake it off.
I put it too. Also, everybody is still out there gelling, trying to feel where they are, because they haven't played a preseason. And this is what you call knocking the rust off. And when you've got Marcus Peters back, who hadn't played in a year, and Marlon Humphrey with a groin, and some rookies out there chasing the cheetah and the penguin, that's a little tough. So that's all right. You know, Marianne, there's a bunch of games left. This is the second game in the season.
Mm-hmm.
So shake it off, Taylor Swift. Shake it off.
Yeah, sometimes it could be motivating. Like, not going to do that again.
I know a bunch of teams that started off, you know, 3-0 and then, or 4-0, and ended up the season like 4-what? How many games we play? Like 4-13 or something. So, you know, this is going to be a spark for how we're going to play, you know, for the rest of the season, because we don't want something like this to dictate us in the playoffs. Like, this is an AFC game. So, you know, these games like this, we got to have, and, you know, have on our belt. So, you know, when they make that decision, they can say we beat a Miami like that. So, We know what we got to do at this point.
We got serious questions to answer, like, was it pizza or nachos at Marianne's house? They were. It was almost flip a coin on Friday, and I said, you got to go nachos. They always do pizza. So I'm not sure which direction they went, and I hope they got it down in the first half.
The answer will surprise you when we come back.
If I had artichoke or something in it. All right, Purple Power Hour at Odafe Oweh, week 2, 98 Rock.
We're back. It's the Purple Power Hour. A friend of mine saw that I posted Purple Power Hour, and they were like, are you sure that's not Purple Flower Hour? You would have done you would have known so much more if it was Purple Flower Hour. But no, it's football. And I want to tell you, I'm into it. I'm into football. I watched the whole game, even though in the third quarter, I was like, oh, this game's over. I resisted and watched as it flipped. Let me ask you this. What's it like in the locker room? Are you guys allowed to? I feel like one team got yelled at for being too happy after a loss. The coach was like, we lost, you've got a blah blah blah. What's it like? Is there a big difference?
I feel like guys is it's guys have raw emotions, so like we're obviously upset, you know, at what happened. So everyone knows it's like self-spoken. You're not gonna talk like, you're not gonna be laughing everything, especially after a loss like that.
Okay.
You know, if it depends on the loss, like, you know, we understand as pros that it's any given Sunday, so
right.
Losses can happen because you're playing against other pros. Everyone's good. Everyone's going to make plays. But a loss like that, no, people aren't talking.
Yeah, believe me, being in the locker room after a loss like that, everybody's quiet, taking tape off, turning around. It's home. Hard to get a sound bite.
Oh, yeah.
Fast. Hey,
Odafe, as a reporter in the locker room after a loss, you kind of look for a couple guys that you know will give you a
and they're
a
avoiding
moment.
Eye contact.
Some guys do not want to talk. I remember trying to go up to Earl Thomas. He's like, forget about it. He's not. But you're probably approachable.
I don't know, man. It's like I don't know. I got too much emotions. I want to be smart about, you know, what I'm gonna say. So I might, you know, give you a postponement date or something like that.
Aren't there some players that are known for like just go to them? They'll always give you something. Do you want to be that guy or no?
Doesn't sound like it. Not with a.
I just wear my emotions, I feel like. So I wouldn't be the right guy.
Right.
Orlando Brown Jr. You could always go up to Orlando Zeus. And give you,
Zeus, really?
Yeah, good, bad, or whatever. How about Lamar's day yesterday? First quarterback in league history to have a rushing touchdown and a throwing touchdown of at least 75 yards in the same game. People were chanting MVP, MVP. Mm. He was doing his thing yesterday, 21 of 29, 318 yards and three touchdowns, and then he rushed for 119 yards and that 79-yard score. But he doesn't care. If he doesn't get the win, he doesn't care.
Yeah.
Boy, he's going, ugh. Like, the stat line just seems crazy, but I was there watching it.
Yeah.
It's crazy the things that he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
What about Tua? You had to admire what Tua was able to do. 459 yards passing and six touchdowns.
He had a cool game. But you know, it was more of what we didn't do. But he had a cool game.
Right. Marianne, was it nachos or was it pizza or was it neither?
Football game day, we usually allow junk food. Guess what we did? Mac and cheese, you guys.
Real mac and cheese
did you bake it? Did you bake it?
I didn't bake it, but I make it from like, I don't do a box. Like
something
it's noodles
healthy.
And it's real cheese.
It's seasoned right.
Yeah. We do it right. I indulged. It was a day. I had a big workout, so I allowed it.
Marlon Humphrey's the one that doesn't like mac and cheese, wasn't he? He's like, that's just noodles, cheese noodles. Did you see that? Crazy.
How do you not like mac and cheese, man?
I know.
It's a match made in heaven. Is anyone vegan on the team?
Not that I know of, but I know guys will do like little diets that, you know, they won't eat, you know, certain things, you know, for a certain period amount of time. But I don't know if someone's strictly vegan.
Right. Wait.
Where do you come down on lobster? Is that overrated? Is it all about butter?
That'd be a great post.
I like lobster, but it has to be with some turf, like some steak. Like, I can't just eat just straight lobster and like
turf with the surf.
Turf with the surf, yeah.
Gotcha. Yep. Sweet, man. Well, so the Patriots are this week. I guess you guys, once it's over, you turn your direction to the next game, and that's the next game.
Yep.
Exactly. Let's get into it on the other side. Purple Power Hour.
Hey, it's a Purple Power Hour. Every game, we do it after the game. And this time, it's a special 5 to 6 o'clock. It's going to be that way. We've got the Orioles and the Tigers coming up on the flagship station, football and baseball station I love. Hey, so do you get a rub down?
It's a personal question.
Well, ice tub, you hop in the ice tub. You don't look like an ice tub guy.
That's crazy because you're so right. But like, nah, I'm pushing myself to get in the ice tub. I just left the facility, so I just did a little hot tub ice tub regimen down the
tunnel. Oh yeah, okay. So how many minutes? It's like certain amount of minutes in the hot
contrast. Yeah,
can you imagine?
Like 7, 7, 7, 7.
Oh, wow. Is that new? I know a lot of people are like. Normal people are doing it too, not just professional athletes. Is that something you guys are doing that's new?
I mean, I've been doing it since college, so.
Wow. Okay.
That's where the regular people got it.
Yeah, I guess so.
Athletes. Mm. And Deshaun Watson took it over the edge. He was getting massage therapists from all over the place. Do you find to, look, I've been getting a couple. I got two massages in the last month. And once you find somebody good, you want to stick with them. I couldn't see jumping all around. So do you have somebody that rubs you down, gets your kinks out?
Hell yeah. Shout out Christian Hicks. Yeah.
Nice.
That's my masseuse, but you know, it's every professional. None of that. So I was all professional. I do everything professional.
Of course.
Yeah. You're not finding them on Insta.
Yeah, no. You don't find him on Instagram. It's a different touch too. All that aside, but I mean, like I think probably Kirk, what you're doing is probably different than what Odafe needs after a game.
Oh, I'm not getting a snowstorm on a mountain or anything yet. It's all all the.
Hey. You're going crazy. You're going crazy.
When you go on the road, do you worry about your food at a hotel or them? Like, hey, that's enough. He always trying to get. He's ordering room service, and in New England, they might try and mess up your food. How do you eat on the road?
Whoa, that's sinister.
I have an alias on my food apps like Grubhub, DoorDash, Uber Eats.
See, you don't have to use the kitchen anymore, Marianne, downstairs at the hotel.
Yeah. No continental breakfast, a little mini boxes of cereal. But
in the old days, you would, if you're in a hotel and they know the football team's in a hotel, you order room service and somebody who's a big fan of that team that you're visiting.
Would sabotage.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Fans do it. Fans are good. Oh my gosh. Whew. That's
They're more into it than, I swear, like family members of yours, I'm sure.
That's what I'm saying. Like, That's a whole person, like another person you're trying.
I wonder what his alias is.
Let me ask you about workouts, though, just because you jumped into that a little bit. Have you heard of Orange Theory?
Oh, no, shit.
What's that?
I did that in Tampa.
You did?
Oh, yeah.
What's that?
Orange Theory. So it's like a new, I don't know. I guess it's not new, but everybody's been telling me you go and you do rowing machine in a group and then you do cardio and then you have to get your heart rate in the orange zone, which is like fat burning or something.
And then you see your name up on this big screen and they say, all right, pick it up, Marianne. You're down.
Imagine if Adolphe was in the class. That would be amazing. Okay. So what about yoga or Pilates? Anything like that?
Yoga. I did yoga a lot in the off season.
So good for you, right?
So good. Helps with breathing as well. Underrated. Yep.
Great.
What about ballet?
Yeah, ballet.
Is it ballet?
Yeah.
No.
A lot of the guys do ballet.
Is that a joke? Are you guys?
No, they do.
I don't know if they still do, but in the old days they would.
Mm-hmm.
Ballet.
They probably moved on to
yoga. Old linemen would be doing ballet. Like
it's kind of like there's a point class. It's called point. And it's similar to Pilates and yoga. I mean, it's just all core. It's hard. It's really awesome. Oh, maybe we'll talk him into it.
Oh, I don't know about that one.
Get you an instructor. Hey, Purple Power Hour powers on. Tough game yesterday, 42-38 loss. But the good news is everybody in the division lost. So the Ravens and the Patriots coming up on Sunday on the flagship. We got more with Odafe coming up next.
All right, yesterday's game was yesterday's game. Now we're looking on to next week, Sunday against the Patriots. Where's your head right now?
You know, I'm just trying to continue to get better every week, you know, cause more havoc, cause more production, you know, just help my team win.
And Matthew Judon, Lawrence Guy, they've got a couple of ex-Ravens up there you're wearing. Judon's 99 jersey. Now it's Odafe Oweh's 99. I saw a couple of your jerseys in the stands. How was the crowd yesterday? Could you feel the energy coming? Because we did Ravens game day from Ravens Walk, and it was packed.
Yeah.
The weather was good. Everybody was awesome. Fired up, getting their drink on, yelling. Mm-hmm. So can you feel that energy on the field? Because I could.
No, yeah, I always say that the flock is crazy, especially in like – night games, but I definitely felt it, you know, being the first home game, you know, seeing the fans and everything. I just wish we got the dub for them. That's the only thing.
Fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Did you say get the dove?
The dove. The W.
Oh, bad. W. I'm the like, dove. Wait, is there some tradition with doves?
Nah, it's a dove.
That I didn't know about. The W.
And Marianne, you know what happens when you're trying to get the chip. You know what the chip is?
No.
Odafe, you want to tell her?
The chip. Are you talking about the champion? The championship?
Yeah. Championship. The chip.
You don't know what the chip is?
I don't.
You don't do sports at all. Huh?
I don't, but I'm learning. I'm learning.
Okay.
Listen, Odafe, you get four tries to make 10 yards, and that's a first down.
Whoa.
Hey, how old? My son, the game will come on. He'll go in the other room and start gaming. How long did it take you? Were you into football as a kid? Because I knew you were a basketball guy, but did they have to kind of set you in front of the TV? How did you learn the rules? Because they're not that easy. How long did it take you to get down?
I mean, college, high school. That's why you didn't see me a lot in the early parts of my college. I was just trying to learn, all the rules.
So as a little kid, did you watch football?
Nah, I was a basketball guy.
Basketball, yeah. Basketball, you said that earlier.
I love basketball. Like, my first game I went to with my dad, I think I was like 8 or something, was in MetLife. The Jets were playing the Giants. So that was like the only time I had any NFL experience or any watching any type of football.
And then your parents didn't watch? Your dad?
No.
Because if your parents watch, you watch. You know what I mean? Exactly. My daughter is watching.
My parents watched the NBA. They love the NBA.
Okay. There it is.
My dad didn't watch any football at all. He was watching opera and nature shows. But my mom was downstairs yelling at the TV, "Get up! Go!" And that's where I got it from, with my mom. But so yeah, you're right. But my son, so far, he's not really picking it up. And you can't push it on somebody. They got to want to do it.
How far did you push going to play basketball? Like, when did it turn?
You could have been a power forward. You could have been probably a small forward at this height.
I feel like when I was playing basketball was like, I feel like God did it for a reason, because like the transition to what my position was and to what it is now wasn't what I was practicing on, like having the handles and all that stuff. Nowadays, like a 6'6" person, like that's a point guard.
Before
it was like a shooting guard, small forward, and something like that. But no, that's a point guard now. So,
Sure.
I would say like basketball. I was just, that was really what I wanted to do. That's what I saw myself doing. So. That's why I'm saying I'm living my second life. Like, I was really like NBA. That's where I was going. And something just switched, and now I'm in the NFL. So
you had to take some time and go, do I really want to put my foot in the ground and go towards football, or do I want to continue what I've been doing my whole youth? So that had to take that's heavy. But you
picked
the
right amazing plan B.
Crazy plan B. Not even knowing.
Your plan B was the NFL.
Hey, how about Hayden Hurst though? He went to baseball first, got the yips, couldn't keep his fastball straight, then went and was a first round draft pick by the Ravens as a tight end.
That's life.
Yeah, man.
It is life.
Listen, we're excited for this season. Yesterday was an anomaly.
It's in the rearview mirror.
That's right.
We're gonna get a dub.
Don't give up on us, Flock. Don't do that.
Never.
Don't do that.
No, that's not how we do it around here. It's a drinking town with a football problem. All right. Hey, thanks a lot, Odafe. And we'll talk with you after hopefully a win against the Patriots.
Yep, yes, sir.
Have a great week.